गुड मॉर्निंग स्टूडेंट। इन लास्ट लेक्चर वी हैव डिस्कस अबाउट द मैक्सिमम पावर ट्रांसफर थ्योरम एंड इन दिस लेक्चर वी विल डिस्कस अबाउट द सुपरपोजिशन थ्योरम एंड द टैंजेंशियल थ्योरम। सुपरपोजिशन थ्योरम, सो सुपरपोजिशन नाम एज द नेम सजेस्ट सुपर प्लस पोजिशन। ओके, मतलब जब हम नोडल के थ्रू करंट निकाल सकते हैं, वोल्टेज मैश के थ्रू करंट निकाल सकते हैं, थेवेनिन थ्योरम के थ्रू निकाल सकते हैं, तो व्हाट इज द इम्पोर्टेंस ऑफ सुपरपोजिशन थ्योरम, यानी सुपरपोजिशन हम कहाँ लगाएंगे। तो एवरी थ्योरम हैज इट्स ब्यूटी। थेवेनिन की अपनी एक ब्यूटी है, नॉर्टन की अपनी एक ब्यूटी है, सुपरपोजिशन की एक अपनी ब्यूटी है। सुपरपोजिशन थ्योरम हम वहां यूज करेंगे व्हेन द सर्किट हैज ए नंबर ऑफ वोल्टेज सोर्स एंड करंट सोर्स। तो इजी क्या है, मैं क्या करूं, जितने भी सोर्स हैं केवल एक बार में एक सोर्स की करंट ले लूं, बाकी सोर्स को हटा दूं। सोर्स हटाने का सिग्निफिकेंस क्या है, इफ द सर्किट हैज वोल्टेज सोर्स मेक द वोल्टेज ऑफ दैट सोर्स इज जीरो, यानी आप वोल्टेज सोर्स को शॉर्ट कर दो। अगर सर्किट में करंट सोर्स है तो उसकी करंट को जीरो करना है, यानी हमें क्या करना है, करंट सोर्स को ओपन करना है। तो फर्स्ट व्हाट द थ्योरम स्टेट, सो सी द थ्योरम स्टेट दैट एल्जेब्रिक सम ऑफ वोल्टेज और करंट across an element is the sum of voltage or current provided by individual sources. Okay, taking one source at a time and other source are deactive. Same, deactive means voltage source ko aap short karein, current source ko open karein. So here we have shown a network. Suppose we have a network. अब नेटवर्क कैसा होगा, लिनियर। लिनियर का सिग्निफिकेंस क्या है, सर्किट हैज ओनली कैपेसिटर इंडक्टिव एंड रेजिस्टिव टाइप एलिमेंट, नो इलेक्ट्रॉनिक्स एलिमेंट। ओके, सर्किट मे हैव डिपेंडेंट सोर्स और इंडिपेंडेंट सोर्स, एंड इंडिपेंडेंट सर्किट मे हैव एसी सोर्स और डीसी सोर्स। सो सपोज इन ए सर्किट ए रेजिस्टेंस एंड इज गिवन। ओके, this resistance R as shown is the part of linear passive network and we have to calculate suppose I or B across this resistance. So what we have said, circuit has the n source, so final current I is the sum of individual current I1 plus I2 up to the IN. I1 is the current of source 1 current, I2 is the source current of and IN is the source current of N. But always remember, when we are considering this I1 current, okay, due to the source 1, other source are deactive. Other source means, agar voltage source hai short kar do, current source hai to open kar do. But one thing more important also, this sign that the final current direction, that is I is representing the total current. Okay, direction of individual current I1, I2, IN, when you are considering the source I1, the direction of I1 should be assumed in the direction of current I. Ab jab I1 ki current ki direction le rahe ho to wo bhi aap I ki direction mein loge. I2 agar leke chal rahe hain wo bhi hum I ki direction mein leke chal rahe hain, तो I1, I2 up to the IN current direction is also in the direction of I. And mathematically, the value of I1, I2, IN either may be positive or negative. So final current I is the sum of individual current. Same with the voltage B, V1, V2 up to the VN. कुछ important point है जिन्हें मुझे ध्यान रखना है जब मैं थेवेनिन सुपरपोजिशन थ्योरम यूज करूं। फर्स्ट, सुपरपोजिशन थ्योरम इज एप्लीकेबल ओनली फॉर वोल्टेज एंड करंट। थ्योरम केवल मेरी वोल्टेज और करंट के लिए एप्लीकेबल है। ठीक है, फाइनल वोल्टेज बी इज बी वन प्लस बी टू अप टू बी एन, आई टोटल करंट आई इज द सम ऑफ आई वन प्लस आई टू अप टू द आई एन, बट इट इज नॉट द केस ऑफ द पावर. सेकेंड इंपॉर्टेंट पॉइंट, नेवर डीएक्टिवेट द डिपेंडेंट सोर्स, only deactivate the independent source. Independent source is deactivate. Voltage source का voltage zero करना है, current source का current zero करना है, but never deactivate. Dependent source को हमें छेड़ना भी नहीं है, circuit में जैसे हैं हमें उसी तरह रखना है. Okay. Third, if because we have said that the superposition theorem is applicable for the voltage and current, then what about the power? So here we have shown an example. See here. Okay, यहां हमने दो सोर्स दिखा रखे हैं, सोर्स आई एस वन एंड द सेकेंड सोर्स इज आई एस टू, एंड द पावर ऑफ आई एस वन इंडिविजुअल प्रोवाइड ए सर्किट दैट इज लिनियर पैसिव नेटवर्क सपोज पी वन, एंड दिस सोर्स आई एस टू इज प्रोवाइडिंग द पावर पी टू. And there is one resistor in linear passive network. And suppose IS1 is providing the current I1 and IS2 is providing the current is I2. So final current in this resistance is I1 plus I2 or I1 minus I2. अगर ये दोनों एक दूसरे को सपोर्ट कर रहे हैं तो प्लस साइन के साथ आ जाएंगे, अदरवाइज कैसे हो जाएंगे, अपोजिट साइन के साथ आ जाएंगे. So individual power of the sources P1 and P2, if both are working simultaneously, then power P is equal to P1 plus P2 or not? Question is that. So what is the power P? मुझे ये find करना है. So see, it is clear when both are working simultaneously, the total current is I1 plus I2. So first, the total power P is given by I square R. So now this I can be replaced as I1 plus minus I2. If they support each other, then take with the positive sign. If they are opposed each other, taking with the negative sign. So I total is I1 plus minus I2 whole square I square R. So when we open this expression, this is I1 square plus I2 square plus minus 2I1 I2 R. 2I1 I2 R can be write as 2 root of I1 square R into root of I2 square R, or this is equivalent to 2 root of P1 plus P2. So final P1 power is P1 plus P2 plus minus 2 root of P1 P2. So remember, current I1 is if individual current is I1 I2, so final current is I1 plus minus I2, voltage is V1 plus minus I2, but in case of power this is P1 plus P2 plus minus 2 root of P1 P2. Clear? So now move to the next slide. Now here we have shown an example based on superposition theorem. So see क्या है, हियर वी हैव शोन एन एग्जांपल, द सोर्स हैज टू इंडिपेंडेंट सोर्स 4 एम्पियर एंड 20 वोल्ट एंड वन डिपेंडेंट सोर्स दैट इज द डिपेंडेंट वोल्टेज सोर्स एंड इट इज डिपेंडिंग अपॉन दिस करंट आईए, दिस करंट इज आईए. ओके, सो दिस वोल्टेज डिपेंडिंग अपॉन दिस करंट, सो दैट इज एन करंट डिपेंडेंट वोल्टेज सोर्स. ओके, so question is saying that find the value of this IA using superposition theorem. So what our target is, current is, this current IA is the sum of two current because circuit has two independent 4 ampere and second is 20 volt. So here we have assumed two current IA dash plus IA double dash. This IA dash current due to this 4 ampere source. Okay, and this IA double dash is the current due to this 20 volt source. Clear? So we have taken the final superposition theorem. IA is equal to IA dash plus IA double dash. Third, that is a dependent source, so never deactivate this. So this remains same as in normal circuit. Okay. Okay. So now, first we are considering first case first. we are taking the 4 ampere source and this 20 volt source is short circuit, and we are solving this problem using mesh analysis. So suppose current in this is I1, in this loop is I2, and in this loop is I3. So first, this loop one has the current source, so we cannot apply the KVL. Okay, but this I1 current is equivalent to the value of 4 ampere. Okay, so my first I1 become equal to the 4 ampere. Clear? Now we are applying the KVL in loop 2. So this is my loop 2. Okay, now we are starting from this point. This point is suppose A. This point is suppose B. This point is suppose C. And this point is suppose D. Okay, now we are applying the KVL in A, B, C, D, A. So starting from A point, first 2. So this is 2I2. Current in this branch is 2. Now moving here, we are getting the negative sign. So this is minus 5A dash. And then 1 ohm is in the direction of current. This is I2 minus I3. And 3 ohm resistance has the current as I2 minus I1. Okay, so this is my second equation. First equation is I1 equal to 4 ampere. And this is my second equation. Okay, so this is my second equation. Now we are applying the KVL in this loop. So DC, ABCD, this point is suppose E. Okay. And this point is suppose F. Okay, so now we are applying the KVL in DCEFA. DCEFA. So starting from D point, so current 1 ohm is I3 minus I2. So this is 1 I3 minus I2 plus 5 IA dash plus 4 I3. And this is 5 I3 minus I1 equal to 0. So this is my third equation. So we have three unknown variable, and using the solving this, the value of IA dash become equal to 52/7. What the value of IA dash? IA dash value is equivalent to I1 minus I3. So calculate the value of using 1, 2, 3, I1, I2 and I3. And this IA dash is equal to the current of I1 minus I3. Okay, because here we have shown the current IA dash and loop current I1 is from here and I3 is opposite direction. So final current is I1 minus I3. So IA dash is 52/7. So now clearing the drawing and move to the next slide. And now case 2. In case 2, we have opened this current source. There is no current source. And now we are considering the voltage source as 20 volt. Okay, and current due to the 20 volt source is assuming as IA double dash. So this is open, no need of this. So now assume the current in this loop is I4 and in this loop is I5. Okay, so now we are applying the KVL in this, starting from this point, then this point, this point, this point. Okay, you can give the name as A. Again, this point is suppose B, this point is C, and this point is D. Okay, so starting from A, B, C, D, A. So starting, that is first term is 2I4, then minus 5IA double dash plus I4 minus I5 and plus 3I4 equal to 0, and solve this. This is equivalent to this. Now applying the KVL in loop 5, this is my loop 5. So starting 1 ohm has the current at I5 minus I4, then 5A double dash, then 4 ohm, this 4 ohm has the current I5, so this is 4I5 minus 20, then minus 20 plus 5, I5 equal to 0, so this become equal to this. So this I0 double dash is opposite to the I5. So this IA double dash is now become equal to minus I5. solving this equation, IA double dash is become equal to the value of this. When we solve this IA, this is IA dash plus IA double dash, so the final current become equal to the minus 8/7. So in superposition theorem, important is this, consider 1/1 source. When you are considering the one source, other source are deactive and final current is the sum of individual sources. Clear? Now moving on the Talienchen theorem, important theorem. So before starting the Talienchen theorem, okay, so first review the complex power. What is the complex power in my circuit? So always remember total complex power. S is has one real power and second is imaginary power. So this is total complex power is the sum of P plus JQ and it is equivalent to half B into I complex. Okay, we have derived this expression into the lecture, is just previous lecture. So if you have any doubt, so just follow the previous lecture. We have discussed about the complex power. Okay, so S is half B into I. B and I are the maximum voltage and current across the circuit. So complex power is, suppose voltage B and I has the angle theta B and theta I. So S is represented as BRMS. BRMS is representing B by root 2, voltage B by root 2 and current IRMS into theta B minus theta I. So this is my total complex power. So apparent power is S is total magnitude of this power. So this is equivalent to BRMS into IRMS and this is equivalent to the real power square plus reactive power square into the root. Okay, so what is real power? So just real power, take the real part of this power as cos theta B minus theta I. While reactive power in the circuit is S sin theta B minus theta I and the power factor of the circuit is P by S. So that is cos theta B minus theta I. So this is related to the complex power of the circuit. Here we have shown that is the total power of the circuit. Okay, this is real power and that is an reactive power. Okay, so in impedance form, it can be represented as real power is across the resistance, reactive power across the reactive element, capacitance and inductance, and this theta, and this is representing the total impedance Z. So it is represented in the form of power, it represented into the form of impedance, and this third is representing the lead or lagging. So if theta B minus theta I is leading with the power P, and here that is the lagging power. So plus Q and minus Q power, we have shown the leading and lagging case. Okay, now what is Talienchen theorem? Okay, first Talienchen theorem is applicable for any type of network based on conservation of energy power. So network may be linear or non-linear, active or passive, or unilateral or bilateral. Circuit may have any type of element. This theorem is applicable for any type of circuit. Okay, second important, this is based on the conservation of the power. So total, what is the total power, conservation of power? Delivered by the sources in a circuit is equal to the power dissipated in the element, or it states that algebraic sum of all power in a circuit is zero, or power supplied by the source is equal to the power supplied by the indifferent element. Okay, so important is for resistive case, when you are calculating the power, suppose circuit has the n number of source, P equal to Vi into Ii into source from I0 to n. If you are talking about the complex load, this is equivalent to voltage into I of conjugate. Okay, source is from 0 to n. Before going through the example, some important point that source may deliver the power or source may consume the power. So here we have shown a case. There is a battery B and current is going from negative to positive. So power P is always represented as minus VI. And minus sign is representing that this source is delivering the power. मतलब ये सोर्स मेरे सर्किट को पावर दे रहा. Whenever current is entering from negative to positive terminal, consider power with negative sign P equal to minus VI and its mean this is providing the power to the circuit. Same here we have represent the current source and the polarity is plus minus. Again, current is moving from negative to positive. Its mean this source is giving the power to the circuit. But when the current in a source move from positive to negative, take its value with the positive sign, and it's mean it is consuming the power. So it's mean it is consuming the power from the circuit. It is not delivering the power to the circuit. Important point. Okay. So if a current is entered from the negative sign, then it delivering the power to the circuit, and if it is entering from the positive sign, it's mean it is consuming the power. So this case and this case we consider with the positive sign, and in these both cases, this case and this case, the circuit is consuming the power, and resistance is always consume the power. So P equal to VI, or you can take I square R or B square upon R, all are the positive power. Clear? So now we are discussing one problem on the Norton theorem. So see, here we have shown a numerical. There is a source 10 volt, 2 ampere, 5 ohm, 2 ohm, 5 ohm, and so the Talguenshan power, prove the Talguenshan power for this circuit. Okay, now we are solving this using the nodal analysis. So assume the circuit has two nodes. This is node 1 and this is my node 2. Okay, and assume the potential of this node is VA and this is in ground. So now we are applying the KCL at this node. Okay, so potential of this node is VA and we are getting the positive sign. So first term is VA minus 10 upon 5, resistance is 5. And second case, now current in this branch is, because VA and resistance 5, so this term is, second term is VA upon 5. This 2 ampere current is moving here, coming current, so taking with negative sign. So VA minus 10 upon 5 plus VA upon 5 minus 2 equal to 0. So when we solve this equation, solving this equation, the value of VA become 10. Okay, then what is the value of current I1? So I1 is VA minus 10 upon 1. So the value of current I1 is 0 because VA value is 10. 10 minus 10 upon 10 is 0. Then what the value of I2? Okay, I2 is the current in 5 ohm resistance. So this is VA by 5. So this current is 2 ampere. Now see, now in this figure we have shown, suppose this is the power of P1, so 10 volt is providing the power P1, 5 ohm is P2, this circuit power is 5 ohm resistance power is P3, resistance 2 ohm power is P4, and this power 2 ampere suppose P5. So because the current in this branch is 0, so power P1 value is 0 because current value is 0. P2 is again 0 because there is no current, so no power across the 5 ohm resistance. Now P3, the current in this resistance is 2 ampere, so power P3 is I square R. So this become equal to 2 square into 5, that is 20 watt. Power P4, see this power resistance is always consume the power. Current is 2 ampere, so this is 2 square into 2, that is 8 watt power. Now see this current source. Now current source, first we have to find the voltage value across this current source. Okay, so now we are applying, so I am just clearing the drawing. So see, now we are applying the KVL in this loop. Okay, so starting from this point, we are getting the negative sign. So this is minus B. Then 2 ohm resistance, current is 2 ampere. So this is 2 into 2. Again, 2 into 5 equal to 0. So B become 14 volt. So to voltage across 2 ampere source is 14 volt. So power this source due to the is 14 into 2. Why we are taking the negative sign? Because current is moving from negative to positive terminal. It means it is delivering to the power to the circuit. So this is minus 14 into 2. This become minus 20 into 8 volt. So total power P become P1 plus P2 plus P3 P5 and total power become equal to the G. Okay, so this power, so Telgensian power is proved in this case. In last lecture, we have discussed a problem for the AC cases. Okay, so if you want to see the Telgensian theorem, you can just follow the last lecture which we have discussed as the lecture number 7. Important, so that is a Telgensian theorem. Okay, so in next lecture, okay, today we will stop here, and in next lecture we will discuss about the transient response for the first order circuit. What is the significance of first order? First order circuit means the differential equation is governed by the first order. So first order circuit is the RL circuit or RC circuit. A number of numerical problem comes from this lecture. Okay, so ye important ho jayega mere liye. फर्स्ट ऑर्डर आर एल सर्किट जानना और आर सी सर्किट जानना. ओके, बट इम्पोर्टेंट क्या है, मुझे अपने टाइम को भी मिनिमाइज करना है टू सॉल्व द प्रॉब्लम. मुझे टाइम कितना मिनिमाइज कर सकता हूँ, छोटी छोटी ट्रिक क्या होती है, इनिशियल कंडीशन में कैसे अप्लाई कर रहा हूँ, फाइनल कंडीशन में कैसे अप्लाई कर रहा हूँ, ठीक है, एंड टाइम कॉन्स्टेंट लेके मैं कैसे प्रॉब्लम सोल्व कर सकता हूँ. वी विल डिस्कस ऑल दीज ऑल टाइप ऑफ स्टेप इन टू द नेक्स्ट लेक्चर. So for an linear to know about the linear circuit theory completely, it must be necessary to know about the transient response. Basically, it is the heart of network and system. Okay, so this also very important for the analog circuit. Okay, we will discuss in next lecture, that is the transient response. Thank you very much.